Good morning, guys. I'm glad all my friends are here to join me today. Here's an update what's going on at Kilauea Volcano there in Hawaii. One of my friends there say they take a walk up there by Kilauea every week, sometimes three times a week. I hope you're wearing some kind of mask, face protection from the gases and the fog. They say they are worried about another collapse of the caldera wall there at Kilauea. Yeah, I would be too, and I worry about your safety when you're taking your walks up there. Please be safe. There's been 101 earthquakes reported in the last 24 hours there on the Big Island of Hawaii, the largest being a magnitude 3.7 by the East Rift Zone, Fern Forest, Hawaii. 7 earthquakes in the last 24 hours over a magnitude 2.5, and most of them down here by Bahala. I'm going to start with this magnitude 2.9. It was deep, 36 kilometers in depth, but looking at the spectrograms for Kilauea, you can see here at this one monitor, OTLD, brought up a lot of magma there at the summit. This is an area, let me bring it out, where there's been a lot of very shallow earthquakes. I have not marked them all. Here's Kilauea and the Halemaumau crater. Over here we got KKOK, and up here is OBL. 42 earthquakes in this location, like I said, very shallow, 1.5 kilometers in depth, 2.1, 1.5, 1.3, 1.0, 0.9. What else do we have here? Another 0.9. Now, all earthquakes are measured from sea level. Here's a 0.4 kilometers in depth, a 1.3. A 1.1, 0.9 kilometers, a 0.4, 0.8 kilometers, a 0.3. Again, this is just within the last 24 hours. And the center monitor is from that location. Let me make this one bigger. All right, we got another earthquake there at 17 minutes after midnight universal time. And look at all of them marked in red. That earthquake supposedly happened over there by Fern Forest, a magnitude 3.7. So that would be about 4.6 miles below sea level. Had me wondering about the conduit, which fault zone, which fracture is bringing up this magma. We got another fairly large one right there. Let's take a look at it. That supposedly was a magnitude 2.8, 8.8 kilometers in depth, 3:36 universal time. A magnitude 2.4, only 2.8 kilometers in depth. Yeah, looks like to be along that fracture zone where a lot of earthquakes have been happening going up to Kilauea. Another one, a 2.0. Again, there at the summit of Kilauea at 5:50 and 54 seconds, and that's what it looked like. But if you look at it, we had blobs of magma coming in near the end. 5:33, again at the summit, supposed to be a magnitude 1.5 at 5:33 and 55 seconds. There's its signature. They, I believe, were off on that magnitude. It was actually a magnitude 2.59. Another one at the summit, they're saying, was 1.8 at 6:37. But I get a magnitude 2.09. Yeah, not a 1.8. Another one at Kilauea. They're saying it also was a magnitude 1.8. At 7:22, there's a signature. They greatly downgraded that one too. It's actually a 2.28. At 9:51, there where they're having the swarm at Palahala. I don't see it on this monitor, but there is one at 8:52 and at 10 o'clock. They're saying it was a 2.9 there at Pahala over there on the side. But I come up with a 2.88, fairly close. And you can see there was one afterwards right there at 10:01. They're saying that is a magnitude 2.4, also Pahala. But I come up with a 2.51. Most of the magma that seems to be coming up from all the southwest, I would say, going up then towards this area where the monitor KKO is, and then probably going into the crater there at Kilauea. And earlier at KKO, this is what the monitor was showing, lots of activity. I'll just bring it down, 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 and then it settled down. But it was really active for a while. Like I said, it settled down, and then we got some other activity. This is 3:29 Universal Time. I'll show you the signature right there, and we'll bring it across. And I'll go back to the spectrogram during that time frame. Let's see, what do we got here? 3:31. 3:36, you can see it settled down. We got some down here at 9:19. This is when I just pulled the files, going back about 24 hours. 12:56, you can see this is at the end where I pulled the files today. I noticed a big dip up over here. Let's take a look at that. We'll take a look at its signature. I don't want to make this bigger. Let's take a look at it. Yeah, harmonic tremors. 11:34. 11:42. I'm just kind of jumping around. 11:18. Yeah, 10:13. Yeah, that's a wow moment. They still have the alert level for watch. Looking down inside Halemaumau Crater. Looks like we got a little spot there. I made it bigger. It's kind of hard to tell, but yeah, it does kind of look like we got some heat coming up there. And the image that I made bigger for you, I noticed it doesn't have a timestamp. They used to have timestamps on them. It has it here at 14:40 Hawaii time, but not on the enlarged image. The thermal image has not been updated since 4:38. There's that little line I was talking about. This one does have a timestamp. There it is right there. That other one didn't, which makes me wonder why. You know, Michael Pollan, who's now the scientist in charge for Yellowstone, he used to work there at HVO there in Hawaii many years ago. Seeing the overlook vent to Halemaumau Crater. That hasn't been updated since 4:37 also. Yeah, the question is, why? Yeah, I wonder if this is even real. So, what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your information. Please be safe if you're taking walks up there along the rim. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.